Please like the video and subscribe my channel to get updates. Also press bell icon to receive notifications of new uploads. Hello all, I Dr. Ajay Verma welcome you to Mac and Mess. In today's video, we will be talking about projections of points. Again, one of the important topic as far as engineering graphics is concerned, because this forms basis for projections of straight line and the topics which are coming after that one, like projection of planes, projection of solids and many more. So let us start with the projection of planes. In my previous video, I gone through theory of orthographic projection, right? So I will provide the link for that video also, so that you will be aware of all these structures, reference plane system, XY line, that is reference line, quadrants, first angle projection, third angle projection and many more. So here we are having vertical plane and horizontal plane, as we have discussed in the previous video. As far as projection of points are concerned, we have to consider position of the point in the space system or in the reference plane system, whether it is in first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant or fourth quadrant, and accordingly we are going to draw the projections, right? So let us start with the position of the point in different quadrants. Say for example, a point A is here in the space and it is having some distance from the HP, that is, say for example, this much of distance from HP and this much of distance from VP. So we will call this point as above HP in front of VP. Say this distance is 30 mm and this distance is 20 mm. So we will draw the projections because we are looking from this direction. So what will happen? The front view of point A will be drawn say here, and this is A dash, and the top view of this point will be drawn on HP, say this one, and this is A. Now we will rotate this HP so that it will coincide on the vertical plane. So what will happen? This point will also rotate and comes somewhere around here. Now because we have rotated it like this, so this point which is top view comes here, and when we remove the system and draw the projections, so what will happen? This is XY line. Now from the front, this 30 mm is visible and this 20 mm is not visible to you from front side, because this distance we cannot judge from the front. So only 30 mm is visible in the front view, that is distance from HP. So we will mark distance from HP, that is 30 mm, and put a dot which will represent A dash. So how A dash will be drawn? Say this point, so from here to here it is, this is also 30 mm, this is also 30 mm. So we can draw a line 30 mm from XY line, right? Now for top view, you have drawn this top view on this HP, so this distance is 20 mm from here to here, right? So when we rotate it like this, what will be this distance? This will also 20, because this has been rotated like this. Okay, so what we will do, we will draw another point in the top view which will represent this, and it is at a distance of 20 mm from the XY line, that is reference line. So we are marking this SY line first, then we are dropping. So what are the observations? Whatever the quadrant there is, say for example this point A is not in first quadrant but it is in this quadrant. Now say this is point B and the same distances are applicable, means this distance is 20 and this distance is say 30. So when we will draw front view, what will happen? This will be backtracked towards vertical plane and again the same point will be drawn A dash at a height of 30 mm. But in case of top view, now the top view is say here, and when we rotate it this plane like this, so this point will come somewhere around here, that is 20 mm. This will be 20, this will also be 20. So this point will be somewhere, the top view will be here and not in the below position of XY line. In third quadrant, if a point is here, say point C, so what will happen? This point, the front view will be drawn here, say this point, and top view will be drawn here. And after rotation, the top view will go above XY line. But whatever the distance of the point from the VP, that will be visible in the top view, right? So there are few conclusions as far as the projection of points are concerned. And these conclusions are like that. First conclusion, you can see distance of the point from HP in front view only. So first point to be remember, distance from HP will be visible in front view. So always remember, whenever we are drawing the front view of any point, the distance from HP is taken, and these distances are given in the form of above HP, below HP, or on the HP. So these three will be the manner of giving the distances of point from the HP. Second conclusion, that is distance from vertical plane is visible in top view. Always remember, the distance from the front view, that is 30 mm or 20 mm, whatever it is visible in the top view only. Okay, so the manners in which distance of the point from vertical plane is given are in front, behind, and on or in VP. Here also it is on or in HP, on or in VP. So these two conditions we have to remember first. Whenever we are drawing front view, we have to consider the distances from the HP. Whenever we are drawing top view, we have to consider distance from the vertical plane. Now, to remove the confusion, we are having six lines that you may remember, so that the projection of points will not be wrong in any case, right? So what are these six lines? First line, and we will divide it in two categories, for front view and top view. So first is for front view. So whenever we are drawing front view of any point, these three may be the conditions. So what are the conditions? First condition means position of the point we are giving position of the point here and front view where it will be, that will be drawn here. So first point, for front view we have to take distance from HP. So for the condition of above HP, the views are drawn above XY line, right? Second, for the condition of below HP, the views are drawn below XY line, and for the condition of on or in the HP, the views are drawn on XY line. So if we remember these three conditions, only these three conditions are possible for that. So above HP, below HP and on the HP, as per the condition you have to draw the front view. Now you can see here, there is no need to remember above, below, on, right? So in this manner you can remember. When we talk about top view, so second, for top view there will be again three conditions like this. So first one is that maybe first, now in top view the distances from vertical plane are given, so they will be given in the form in front of VP. So the view will go below XY line. For the condition, that is second condition, behind VP, the view goes above XY line, and for the third condition, that is on or in the VP, the view goes on XY, on XY line. So always remember these six lines so that your projection of points problem will not be wrong at all. Few things to be remember. Number one, distance from HP is visible in front view. Second, distance from VP visible in top view. Third, projections of a point are always coinciding on a single vertical line. Always remember this. Say for example, you have to draw one single vertical line which will represent the projectors. This is XY line, and on this single vertical line both the views will be there, either A dash or A, wherever they are, but they must be coinciding on a single vertical line. So in this manner you can draw the projections. Now let us take one example so that we can understand how to draw the projections of points. So we are considering few points here and drawing them on a single reference line, right? So say this is the single reference line, and we are keeping the distance between the projector, that is that vertical line on which both the views will be there. So these vertical lines we are taking, say for example, at a distance of 20 mm. So these are the projectors for drawing the views. Second point, third point, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on. Now let us consider point A. The point A is 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP. So 20 mm above HP. For drawing front view, we will take that dimension. So 20 mm above HP and this is 30 mm in front of VP. So as per our six lines, above HP means the front view will be above XY line. So what we will do, take a distance 20 mm from this XY line and mark a point that will be A dash. Secondly, 30 mm in front of VP. So as we seen there, in front, when the point is given in front, the top view will be below XY line. So 30 mm distance we will take from XY line and that will be point A, that is top view of the point A. For point B, say for example 20 mm below HP and 30 mm in front of VP. So what will happen? 20 mm below HP, this will be A dash, because the point is given in front of VP, top view will also be here, and it is 30 mm in front of VP, so XY to 30 mm another point A dash. This is the point, this is the point which is in fourth quadrant, that is why both the views are below XY line. Say for example a point is on the HP and 30 mm above, on the HP, 30 mm in front of VP. So as per our rules, on the HP, say point C, this will be the front view, and because it is given in front, the next will be 30 mm in front, so this is top view of the point. Say point D is there, which is on in both the planes. How this may be possible? This may be possible when the point is on XY line. Now this point, say for example point D, it is in HP as well as in VP, so that point will be marked on XY line itself, and that will represent D dash and D both, right? A point which is in say 20 mm below HP and 30 mm in front of, behind VP, so 30 mm below HP, here it is, and say for example 20 mm behind VP, so behind, that will go above XY line, so 20 mm behind VP, this may be the top view of the point. So in this manner you can draw the projections of points. Now there is one more thing as far as projections of points are concerned. Distance between two points in the projections using the projection method. So say for example you have been asked to find out distance between point, say any one of the points you can take, but let me take one point with the, say this is the point, point C, where C dash is above HP and C is in front of VP. So that similar type of condition is there, just like point A, right? So this is the position of these two points, right? Now what you have to do, you have to find out distance between point A and C using projection method. What you need to do, first of all join both the front views of these two points, say in this way we have joined them, and draw two perpendiculars, one at A dash, another at C dash, right? You can do this method on top views also. You can join both the top views and draw two perpendiculars in one direction if both the front views are in one direction, or both the front views are one side of the XY line, that is above, then you have to draw these perpendiculars in one direction of like this. Now you have to take distances to cut on these perpendiculars from the another view. So for A dash, you will take distance from XY line to E. This much of distance you have to take and cut on this, like this, okay. Similarly, for C dash, you will take distance from the top view, that is, say for example, this double dash, double tick and cut here, taking center as C dash and this. Now join these two points which are obtained here. Say this is A and this is C. So this AC is the true length of the is the distance between the two points in the space, right? It's something like that. A is here, C is somewhere around here. So this distance we have obtained right now. In case when one front view of one point is above xy line and for another it is below xy line, or vice versa, say for example top view is above and another one's top view is below, then you have to draw these perpendiculars in different directions. Now let us consider, here are two points, one in first quadrant, second one is, say for example, in third quadrant. So their views are in the different sides of xy line. Like for A dash, the front view is above xy line, while for B dash it is below xy line. Similarly, top views are on the other sides of the xy line. So for this type of problem, first join the front views or top views. Say for example, I am joining the front views, and now you have to draw perpendiculars in different direction. If you are drawing perpendicular this side for A, then you have to draw perpendicular this side for B. Say for example, I am taking here one perpendicular and another perpendicular for B in this direction. Now you can cut the distances taking from the other views. So you have to take distance for A from here, that is in the top view. So take this distance from xy to A and cut here. So this is point A, and for B you have to take distance from the other view, that is from xy to B, this much of distance, say it cuts here. So the final distance between these two points is this AB pink color line. It's something like that. Point A is here and point B is somewhere around here, and this distance we have find out. Okay, so in this manner we can do. This method is nothing but it is auxiliary planes method of projection, which we have already discussed in projection of solids in my some videos, right? This method is also called trapezoidal method for finding out distance between two points in the reference plane system. So this is all about for projection of points. In next video we will be talking about projections of straight lines. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel and like my video if you have liked it. Thanks once again.